Hello, my name is Keshwani. It's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. We are here because we want to improve our math skill. Today is our lesson number 160 in the series of basic math. And today we'll do our last lesson, 20th lesson in the series of 20 on the topic of ratio and proportion. The problem for today is already on the blackboard, as you can see. Let's take a look at it. We are told that we have a jar. We are told the jar contains red. We are told the jar contains red, green. Oh, sorry. This is not bloody red. Red. Oh, man. How can I make it so complicated? Red, blue, green, and yellow marbles. We have four colors. A jar contains red, blue, green, and yellow marbles. We are told that the ratio of red to yellow is 2 to 5th. We are further told that the ratio of green to red is 2 to 1. And finally, we are told that the ratio of blue to yellow is 3 to 5th. We are being asked to figure out two ratios. What are the ratios of red to blue and blue to green? What are the ratios of red to blue and blue to green? I will give you now 5 seconds for you to be able to pause and unpause the video. Pause the video, do the problem yourself. Once you have the answer, then compare your work against the work that you and I will do together in a few seconds' time. Do you understand? I'll get out of your way. As I said, I'll give you 5 seconds for you to be able to pause and unpause the video. Well, let's get going. First thing first, we're going to need a lot of room in here. I'm going to have to erase this stuff as we start writing it. So let's first take care of this one. Red to yellow is 2 to 5. Let's put it up here. Red to yellow is 2 to 5. Red to yellow is 2 to 5. So that one is done. We are further told the ratio of green to red is 2 to 1. So that one is gone. And finally, we know the ratio of blue to yellow is 3 to 5. And what we want to find out are ratio of red to blue and blue to green. Let's see what we can do, shall we? Well, as you can clearly see, we want red to blue. So we see a red right here. You see that? We see a red right here. Is that what you were looking for? Red to blue. Oh, there you go. I see a red right here. It is red to blue. We see a red in this one. And red to blue. And I see a blue right here. You see it? I see a red and I see a blue. And lucky for us, the bottom is the same. It's not the fact that the bottom is the same. The point here is that the other factor that they have is actually the same factor. So what do you suppose is going to happen if we take red to yellow, and multiply it by blue to yellow? That's not going to get us anywhere. Instead of multiplying, what we need to do is divide the two ratios. If we divide the two ratios, we can get rid of the y. So now this is same as red to yellow times yellow to blue. The yellow will cancel out and we end up with red to blue. That's all it is. And now we simply plug in our numbers and we will have the answer. Red to yellow we know is 2/5. Times yellow to blue, this is blue to yellow. Make sure you pay attention. This is blue to yellow, so yellow to blue is going to be 5/3. 5/3. And of course, 5 is going to go away, and we end up with 2/3. Red to blue is 2/3. That's it, we're done. Red to blue is already figured out. So I'm going to erase this thing. Now we have to work on the second one, which is blue to green. So we have red to blue. And what we need is blue to green. What we need is blue to green. We already have red to blue. We already have red to blue. I see a blue here, I see a blue here. If we can somehow find a ratio which combines the red and the green, oh, right here, green and the red. You see? Watch my red to blue is what, red to blue is what we know. What we want is blue to green. If we can figure out another ratio which combines the red and the green, a red and the green, we can get rid of the blue and we'll have red and the green. It's right here. It's right here. So, red to blue times green to red, we can get rid of the red and we'll have green over blue, which is red, red to blue, we just found out, red to blue is 2/3, we just found it out, 2/3 times green to red. Green to red is, right here, green to red is 2:1. 2:1. So we end up at 4:3. 4:3 is the ratio of green to blue. Is the ratio of green to blue. Which is exactly what they were looking for, green to blue. Oh, well, actually, they're looking for blue to green. So make sure you pay attention in the exam. One answer is going to be 4/3, the other answer is going to be 3/4. 3/4 is what we're looking for. 3/4 is what we're looking for. This is the reciprocal. So you have to pay attention. That's it. That's your answer. The answer is not 4/3. The answer is 3/4. And the red to blue we found out was 2/3. Was 2/3. Now I'm going to show you a different method. That's it. We're done. As far as the problem is concerned, we're done. But as you can see, the reason I went through this process is for you to be able to appreciate what's going on in this method. As you can see, it can get a little bit more complicated. It can get a little complicated, and it requires a great deal of attention. It is more of an academic method. The method that we just did is a very classical method, very orthodox method, very conventional method. As I said, very very academic method. Now I'm going to show you a different method. Okay, just give me a second. Now I'm going to show you a different method. I need the room. So I'm going to have to erase all of this thing. Okay, here we go. This is an entirely different method. We have to erase this part. We do not know this. So we start from scratch. This is what we want to find out. We want to find out this, and we want to find out this. Well, we have red to blue to green to yellow. I believe that's how we were given. It doesn't matter how I write it. It makes no difference how I write it. But this is how I wrote it. Red to blue to green to yellow. Red to yellow is 2:5. Okay, follow me in this story here. Red to yellow is 2:5. Red to yellow is 2:5. You see where it came from? 2:5, right from the first one. This came from the first ratio. Let's call it the first ratio. Now we're gonna work on the second ratio. Second ratio tells me that green to red is 2:1. Green to red is 2:1. Watch what happens. 2 to red. Pay attention, green is on the top. 2:1. 2:1. This is the second ratio. Now the problem is we cannot leave a 1 here because underneath that red we have 2 here. So we have to convert this into 2. So we're going to do that. We're going to convert this into a 2, and if we convert this into a 2, we have to go back and convert that into a 4. And it's still the same ratio. The ratio of 4:2, ratio of 4:2 is same as 2:1. The ratio is still the same. 4:2 or 2:1 is still the same ratio. But that was the second ratio. But you see how we have to make the adjustment? Now, so we're done with that part, let's move on to third ratio. This is the third ratio right here. And third ratio tells us it is 3:5. Blue to yellow. Where is blue? Blue, right here. Blue to yellow. Oh, right here, yellow. We don't have to do any adjustment at all. This 5 right here comes right down. We don't have to do any adjustment at all because it was 5 to begin with. Oh, we got lucky there. 3:5. So it was 5 there to begin with because remember in the beginning it was 2:5. So that 5 was right there. Had that been 10 and this had been 5, then we would have had to multiply this thing by 2 again. Or had this been 10 and that had been 5, we would have had to multiply this ratio by 2. Divide this ratio by 2. So for example, had this, I'm going to show you here. For example, had it been 3:10, then we would have had to divide this ratio by half to convert this 10 into a 5. Had this been 10, we would have had to multiply this ratio by 2 to convert this 5 into a 10. But we don't have to do any of this thing. It was 5 to begin with. Just bring the 5 down. It was 5 to begin with. Bring it down. Nothing to it. It was 2:5. That 5 just comes down. That's it. We are done. The ratios are 2:3, 4:5. Oh, what do you know? Whoever created this problem, who should remain nameless, was obviously a very creative person. 2 to 3 to 4 to 5. There you go, we have all of our ratios. Now we can answer any ratio. Any ratio that they ask for, we can answer it very quickly. Red to blue is what they're looking for. Red to blue is what we're looking for. We just have to look here. Red, right here. Red to blue, right here. 2 to 3. It is 2 to 3. Red to blue. That we want is blue to green. Blue to green. Blue to green. Oh, there you go. 3 to 4. 3 to 4. 3 to 4 and 2 to 3. That's exactly what we found earlier. So that was a different method. That was another method of doing the same problem. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? Bye now.